Despite constant surveillance by the Cuban government, Dr. Bessette continued with his work for human rights in Cuba. However, in 1999, Dr. Bessette was arrested and given a 3-year prison sentence for disorderly conduct because of his work against the government. Released in late 2002, his freedom was short-lived. After just 36 days of freedom, Dr. Bessette was charged with crimes against state security and this time sentenced to 25 years in prison. Dr. Bessette's arrest and sentence foreshadowed the crackdown to come. In March 2003, the Cuban government arrested 90 human rights workers, journalists, and librarians, and charged them with crimes against state security. Almost all of those arrested during Cuba's Black Spring were given 25-year prison sentences. With Cuba's recent transfer of power from Fidel to Raúl Castro, many outside of Cuba are optimistic about change coming to the island. However, those who know the situation well, especially those inside Cuba, are not so optimistic.
Sabemos que hay muchas expectativas sobre posibles cambios en Cuba. Creo que muchos en el mundo lo desean con buena voluntad. Pero no se puede confundir el deseo con la realidad. Se habla en los medios de difusión sobre cambios en Cuba. Ha habido un cambio. Fidel Castro ya no está formalmente administrando. Pero ese es el asunto en el palacio. ¿Y qué pasa en el pueblo? Sigue la persecución de los cuerpos represivos contra la actividad económica independiente. Sigue la persecución contra el padre y la madre de familia que tratan de buscar el pan de cada día. Siguen los cuerpos de vigilancia, represión, de control en cada calle, en cada escuela, en cada centro de trabajo. Continúan todos los rasgos del totalitarismo activo. Por otra parte, el gobierno, sus voceros, dicen que cambio significa más socialismo. Es cínico, después de 50 años, decir que el cambio significa la sucesión en el poder del mismo grupo, con todo el poder, con todos los privilegios, pero no hablan de derechos.
A recent example of Cuba's continued repression is the case of Gorky Aguila, lead singer for the Havana-based punk rock band Porno para Ricardo. In September 2008, Gorky, whose lyrics are often critical of the government, its leaders, and communism in general, was arrested and charged with social dangerousness, a crime that allows the government to imprison individuals they believe are likely to commit crimes in the future. The charge carries a penalty of between 1 and 4 years in prison. However, because Gorky is well known, news of his arrest grabbed the attention of the international press. At the same time, through the use of new technology, news of the situation spread throughout the island. Feeling the pressure from outside of Cuba, the Cuban government decided to release Gorky to avoid extended negative attention.
Bueno, yo sentí esa ayuda. Más que nunca, cuando esta última vez estuve preso, fue algo para mí apoteósico y fue algo realmente contundente. Que la opinión pública mundial, que muchos artistas, intelectuales, gente de otros oficios, hayan cambiado una decisión de este gobierno. O sea, la decisión, o sea, la orden era meterme preso. Y ellos la cambiaron. O sea, a mí eso me impresionó mucho.
The spread of information via new forms of technology is a hopeful sign to both those inside and outside of Cuba. Yanni Sanchez, an award-winning blogger living in Havana and one of Time magazine's 100 most influential people in the world, writes about her life in Cuba in her blog Generation Y. Although her blog, like many websites in Cuba, has been blocked on the island, Yoni believes that access to information, more than anything else, will bring about the change Cubans desire for their country.
Los mitos que han creado en nosotros la prensa oficial, una especie de paraíso interior, infierno exterior. Cuando viene alguien de fuera y nos cuenta cómo es su vida, eso ayuda mucho. La ayuda de la información creo que es la más importante. Información. En un país donde el gobierno tiene un monopolio informativo, la mejor ayuda que se le puede dar a sus ciudadanos es la posibilidad de acceder a información.
50 years after the revolution, how will the international community respond to this unique opportunity to help bring about the change Cubans thirst for? How will they respond to the call of Dr. Bisset and all those who have risked and sacrificed so much?
Oscar is in a cell block in El Combinado del Este prison, maximum security for him. Oscar gets visits every 45, 60 days. They take him out maybe once or twice a week, 10 minutes to get some sun. He has been in solitary confinements, not only in typical cell blocks that we know, in any regular prison, but undergrounds. He's been in underground cellars for up to 6 months. He is a plantado. That means he does not wear the uniform, nor does he agree to the norms of the prison. And he's been like this for the past, in total, since 1999. It's going to be almost a decade already, with only 36 days of freedom.
Él tiene, dice, puesto en la puerta de la celda un letrero que dice, Dios está aquí esperando por ti. Y todos los presos que van ahí con él es a predicarle la palabra de Dios. Es una cosa tan linda que yo no sé por qué todavía el gobierno no ha liberado a mi esposo, porque es un crimen. Es un crimen muy grande que él esté preso.
Dr. Bisset is not really risking his life, he's giving his life to others. The Cuban government will not be able to break Dr. Bisset. The only way to stop a man of his stature and of his actions is by killing him. Deep inside, they know this, and they fear him much. He once told me that if anyone was ever to ask me whether they were afraid for his life, and if he would die, he told me to answer in the following way. God gave me life, and when my mission is over in this world, he will take it from me.
Y nosotros tenemos una máxima que decimos que cuando un gobierno encarcela injustamente a su ciudadano, el deber de un hombre justo es la cárcel. O sea, que una de las violencias que puede aplicar Castro es la cárcel, y nosotros estamos dispuestos a ir a cumplir esta cárcel por la libertad del pueblo cubano.
Spread the word. Know that there's people in Cuba like Dr. Oscar Elias Bisset and prisoners of conscience. Understand what these people are about. Understand the virtue of their suffering. And denounce it. Go out and denounce it.